Hey, I bought what I wanted already again. Or are they being really nice to me? I got no clue. But either way, we're still trying towards 10k and right now we got 7.8. We're doing good, we just gotta keep up the pace. You've been chuckling since yesterday. Pfft, wiener. Still laughing about that? December 28th today. Oh my god. There's more Y2K references. The final remaster leads the video game charts. The newest remaster of 2016's Y2K, a postmodern RPG, opens the charts this week with 3.5 million copies shipped on its launch day. Other titles this week include new releases such as Hatsune Miku Project Remaster and Sting's Face Remastered. Like Steins Gate? Full chart including lifetime sales. Y2K at the top, Hatsune Miku, Sting's Face, Water Pro Wrestling G. Dang it, Ron Paul. This is the third final this year. They're always gonna make remasters for as long as there's gonna be new people born who were not around when the game first came out. And that's a good thing, right? More people get to experience classics and the story in better graphics and whatever. Women marries anime pillow. Nobody is actually surprised. I remember a time when wacky stuff like this made a lot of headlines, but even though I'm reporting on it, I can't help but think how mundane it's become. I mean, we live in a world where you can just plug into the internet and live there for as long as your wallet can afford related fees. Lots of people get married in these virtual spaces. Thanks to new technologies, the traditional views on human relationships have changed so much that someone marrying a literal object feels kind of tame now. If the pillow had some form of intelligence, it might be somewhat different, but it's just a plain generic anime hug pillow. Get with the times, grandma. Wanna marry me? Can't marry your own son. Yeah, I guess one thing that is always interesting to try to think about is how will technology affect the non-technological aspects of the world in the future? Like something like this nowadays would still make headlines for being weird, but in the future, what if it really does become so mundane that no one cares anymore? Well, there'll probably be a lot more shut-ins. First space colony plans to develop its own army. Even though space was imagined as a promised land, a place where humanity would start over, it looks like we're about to repeat our mistakes from the past. The first space colony, Shin Outer Paradise, Shin means new in Japanese, is currently in talks to develop its own privately owned army, following alleged threats from a notorious terrorist group. We're discussing it right now, but the law is most likely approved. We'll have an army, and we'll defend our motherland from any terrorist threat. Alice Rabbit chimed in during a private stream. This terrorist group does not exist. Don't let the Outer Paradise government fool you. The only reason for this law is so they can have more control over the population. Alice Rabbit is in space too? Amazing. Speaking of Alice Rabbit, yeah, somebody noted that, remember that one night when Alma and Jill were having their talk? And then Alma hacked into the bartending station, right? So for a very quick second, the Alice Rabbit logo flashed. And below it, there was some Japanese, but it was kind of like a misspelling of Alice. I feel like overall, that thing was supposed to imply that Alma is related to Alice Rabbit in some way, but the typo kind of makes me think a little bit. Not sure what it really means, but if you think about it, the Alice Rabbit logo does have a rabbit with blonde hair, and who else has blonde hair? Ooh! That bar called Valhalla. Is it any good? I need a place to unwind after work. Huh, work. Normies are taking over, huh? Everyone is a neat just like me. Anyway, place is cool, but the bartender can be a bit of a dick. How so? Never been there, so I wouldn't know. She cute? I can take it if she's cute. She's cute, but I think she's a bit full of herself. The guy seems a bit more of a bro. I see you already had a conversation with her? Did she reject your advances? Nah, I just heard from the distance. So is that a no? Kinda. I mean, if you're going there just to chat. Can I smoke there? Actually, I do wonder. I don't think so, because Jill smokes outside every time. Yeah. Sounds like people want to come next week, but we might be closed. So I'm full of myself?
You are.
Thanks for weighing in, Thank you. It's gotta work! Every day it gets closer to paying rent, I get a bit more nervous. But also, every new day means that we're gonna see Gabby soon, too. And the whole thing about opening the envelope and all. Good evening. Oh, Jill! I'm out to get firecrackers! Firecrackers? It's New Year's, right? We need some! Wouldn't firecrackers scare off the dog? Yeah, good idea. Go ahead. I'll be back in a bit. Even for a cat lover, you sure get excited about firecrackers a whole lot more when dogs are involved. I know how hypocritical it sounds, and I don't care. Ah, Jamie's here. Greetings. Anyway, let's start. Jamie beelines over to Gil. Fair enough. Yeah, I'm okay. Time to mix drinks and change lives. Oddly enough, even though all we've done all game long is talk to people, I do feel like the lives of the people around us have been slowly changing. Is it because they talk to us specifically? Maybe not, but I like to think that we've helped them in some way just by hearing them out. Ah, the guy that wouldn't come back twice. Yeah, shut up. By any chance, did something fly over here 2 weeks ago? On Friday? Yes. There were lots of weird explosion noises throughout the night. The one night where we heard the sonic boom stuff? But as far as I understand, those were made by a flying drone or something like that. So it flew by here. I take it you know what made the noise? Let's just keep it at whatever drone story you heard. Oh? Didn't Ingram work as an engineer at some place? Maybe it's related to that? Right. The noise got annoying after a while, I must say. So it remained in the vicinity? You make it sound like it's organic or something. I don't know what counts as in the vicinity, but yeah. Distant explosions all night. Interesting. So it didn't get far away. Now, get me a Mars blast. A Mars blast for the guy that wouldn't come back twice. What's up, man? You coming back for your daily happy hour? It's only Wednesday today. But you're always welcome back. You don't have to be so salty every time. I won't treat you that badly. Maybe you're in a better mood today. Oh, we can't do a big one for this one. It's too much. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. Yep. One of these is enough to leave your face red like the actual planet. Here you go. Well, you didn't mess up. Do I ever? Sorry, if I may interject. You looking for a fight? Most certainly not. You really think you'd stand a chance? You're like half his size. I can fight dirty. He kills people for a living. Hey, Jill, what the hell? Why are you outing Jamie's profession? I can fight dirty. Jill, please. You make me sound like a savage. Wait, I thought him being an assassin is not like a well-known thing. Why are you going around telling people that? What happened to confidentiality? It would be like me saying that you get people drunk for a living. It's not wrong, but there are better ways of saying stuff like that. You're right, sorry. Shouldn't be talking about it, period. And like I said, I'm not looking for a fight. I just noticed you seem to like strong drinks. What about it? Well, to be honest, it's a rare sight in this bar. I'd even come to believe I'm the only one here who enjoys them, aside from the owner. May I suggest you try a suplex next time? It might be to your liking. Okay, let's try the suplex thing. Right. Let's give Ingram a suplex. Wow, that sounded weird. Nope, let's give him one. He's kind of a jerk anyway. But did he actually do anything that's super horrible to us? Not really. Aside from being kind of clammy sometimes, but the first time he came here, he was talking all about how I'm so sad, boo-hoo, but not like that. He was saying, oh, but what if everything I told you was a lie? But he was being kind of emo and stuff. That part's true. Mm-hmm. On the rocks. Okay. Here. Good stuff. Like a less burning but punchier pile driver. Say, your face somehow looks familiar, Mr. Call me Jamie. And you are? I'm Ingram. Anyway, I think I saw your face somewhere. Maybe when I needed to look for a specific file at... Did you perhaps go through a nanomachine expunge? I did, actually. Wait, expunge as in removing nanomachines? You can do that? Figured as much. Only a handful of people do that. And almost all of them are people with nanomachine rejection that feel oddly suicidal. Jamie has nanomachine rejection? Didn't really strike me as a type because he seems like he's got all these augments and stuff. Actually, looking at both these guys, these lines on their faces and on Ingram's neck too. Like, it seems like it might be a necklace, but then I look at the screw holes, the little dots, and I feel like that might be some kind of an augment. And in Ingram's case, it's actually kind of scary to think about because it's like, did he switch his head? And then on Jamie's arm here, similar little screw holes too. Apparently, Jamie is supposed to be a reference to Adam Jensen from Deus Ex. And I guess if you look at the hair, yeah. But he seemed a little bit too bulky to me, so I didn't even recognize it. But of course, Adam also has these sunglasses kind of things, but on both eyes, right? And he also has a whole bunch of augments. So, why go through the whole thing? Rejection? Need to hide something? The second one. Oh, okay, so he doesn't have rejection. Which makes sense, because he's got so many augments. It's easier to remain undetected when they have no means to track you or your activity. I see. How does the expunge work? You lie in a pressure chamber, and they give you a special IV solution. It causes nanomachine rejection while giving you the antibodies needed to prevent them from getting back in. What? So the way to get rid of nanomachines is to create nanomachine rejection. It's not like they just open you up and pick it back out. What is a nanomachine anyway? Is it like a small machine? Can you just take it out with a tweezer? Or is it embedded into your bloodstream? Because from what they're saying, it sounds pretty chemical because you need chemicals to get rid of it. For 5 hours, you're trapped in bed while a horrible pressure builds up in your body and nanomachines are forced out. They're like little needles all over your body. You feel them in your eyes, in your gums, in your toes, everywhere. Wait, so Ingram... Does he know this because of the place he works at? He recognizes people that go for a nanomachine expunge because he works for a nanomachine installation facility, maybe? Oh, you're breaking confidentiality too. And after all that, they need to implant you with a mechanism that constantly releases the same antibodies. Ouch. What are you having, Jamie? This is a gut punch. Yeah, should've figured. Hey, give me one of those. Sure. Let's give him a gut punch. Again, that doesn't sound right. I'm pretty sure we did actually want to give him a gut punch the first time he came here. He's so agreeable today. Him and Jamie are having like a bro bonding moment. Well, everybody's gotta find a friend, right? And if Ingram's friend is a assassin... Well, that's not really my place to judge. Kinda messed up here. Did I do it right? All aged? Okay. Here. Yeah, I love these. It looks different from yours, though. I got a couple of extras in his, actually. So where's the antibody unit they stuck you with, Jamie? Inside, like all the other maintenance systems. Wait, so you're getting... The purpose of why you're getting rid of all of your nanomachines is to stay under the radar. But in return, you have to install a antibody maintenance system, which I feel like could also be used to track you, so I'm not really sure if you're really accomplishing what you want to be accomplishing here. My understanding right now is that everybody in Glitch City, as soon as they're born, they have to be injected with nanomachines. Augments are kind of like a different thing, and you can get them if you want to, if you have money, I guess. But nanomachines are basically used for the purposes of tracking. Just like how in the protests earlier in the newspaper, we saw that, oh, the police were forced to use the nanomachines on people. Like, okay, whatever. And that's why people like Stella would have nanomachine rejection at birth, which would be really dangerous because you're just a little baby, man. You don't have antibodies for that. And that's why we get newspaper talking about people dying from nanomachine rejection, even though the number in general seems to be fairly low. 80 people per year. I'm assuming Glitch City is a really populated city, so 80? Not ideal, should be zero, but, you know, in the grand scheme of things, it's not a huge amount. It can be troublesome at times, but the perks of not having nanomachines in the body outweigh the cons. And the rest of the enhancements? Were you reconstructed, or have you been adding them over time? If it's Adam Jensen, it might be a completely new body. Over time, either by getting a much-needed enhancement, or through fixing injuries. I see. Well, it was a pleasure, Jamie, but I gotta leave. Nice meeting you, Ingram. Please come again. Don't count on it. You've said that twice. Shut up. Seemed like a nice guy. No, only because it was you who came up to him. Yeah. I think this might be one of the first times where two customers, independently of each other, just started talking up, just started chatting up in a bar. Even though in real life, that situation would probably happen much more often. I mean, I feel like we've had some other situations like Dorothy talking to Mario, or even Dorothy talking to Say, but these two people seem to really get along. And it sounds like maybe it's the beginning of a blossoming friendship. Or something. Right. I won't call him a bastard, but he's not the nicest in the bunch. Maybe you caught him on a bad day? Nah, I think you're just that good at bringing out the nicer side of people. Oddly enough. Maybe you can get people to drop their guard. Good trait to have. That guy tires the hell out of me. Yeah, no kidding! Two guys on the scene? How the hell am I gonna do voices for both of them? Quit it! Someone's in a good mood. Give me a bad touch, will you? That way, you'll be in a good mood too. A bad touch for Alma. Jill's back to laughing at them. Well, that can't be a bad thing, I suppose. 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 3-4, 1-2, 3-4. Boom. Boom. Here. Jill, you have such a petty sense of humor. Guilty as charged. So, what put you in a good mood? Oh yeah, that. Today, my sister was supposed to be in court for all the custody proceedings. Of course, not only does she show up later than her husband, and drunk at that. So it's like the abusive husband versus the drunk wife? Oh my god, the kids. But also dressed like she got fucked in the back of a parking lot. And to top it off, she forgot to even bring her kids. Luckily, my parents brought them to court. The judge assigned the kids to my parents for the time being. So she really messed it up, huh? When they came back to the house and Diana started throwing a temper tantrum. She said it was lucky her husband didn't get the kids because the angst would make her jump onto the highway. So Eva comes and says, then make sure it kills you, because we aren't dealing with you as a cripple. I shouldn't reinforce that behavior, but... I don't know. Maybe it was the timing, but... I've been laughing for an hour now. I'm not sure how to feel about you laughing. It's like the rest of your family is bonding over shitting on your sister. Which... we all need something to bond over, right? But damn, man, your sister. You hold quite the animosity for Diana, don't you? She and I used to be the closest friends when I was 7 or 8. We played all the time. We even slept on the same bed for a while. Then she turned into a teen. We stopped playing. She had other things she wanted to do. I could forgive all that. I mean, the age difference and all. Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't know, but I feel like there's gotta be a rough period for siblings, especially ones far apart in age, cause at some point, the older one's gonna be like, I'm too cool for the younger one. Get away from me, please. But there is something in particular I still can't forgive. It was the day she invited her friends to the house, and I went to ask her something. As I was leaving, one of her friends asked if I was her sister. And she said she had no little sisters. She had four siblings, and she said she had no sisters. They came to her house, though. If they're not your sisters, who the hell are these random little kids? God damn. Ouch. I think that was the moment that finally broke the pedestal I held her on. I admired her as much as a kid could admire someone, you know? Little by little, that admiration wore off until we finally reached the breaking point. I felt betrayed. I can kind of understand the not cool thing, like the older sister, older siblings being like, "Ew, get away from me." But to outright not even acknowledge that she's your sister, that's not even bullying and saying, "Oh, she's really lame, don't talk to her." That's a denial of someone's existence. That's really mean. And you haven't been able to forgive her after 40 years? Hey. It's not that I still hold a grudge against her, but rather, the Diana who said all those things so many years ago is the same Diana that I know today. How so? She hasn't matured one bit. She's still as selfish, childish, and immature as she was back then. When you see her, you don't see an adult. You see an overgrown, horny teen. So aside from destroying any admiration I held for her, she's made sure not to fix that impression. Huh. But enough about me. How are you? Everything's fine, aside from this note. Oh, good, Jill. You're talking about it by yourself. A note? Remember how I told you I lashed out at my dead girl... dead ex's sister? Yeah. I got this note from her. Let's see. Wow, she must really feel bad about the whole thing. As do I. So, what's the problem then? The same fear that drove me away from her in the first place. Right. Give her Brantini, will you? There's a little story I want to tell you. Right. A Brantini. Earlier, Jill mentioned that it's been 40 years since the dispute between Alma and her sister. As a joke, right? Because there's no way it's been 40 years. Kind of makes me wonder how old Alma is. I kind of assumed she was around the same age as us, but, well, if she is, I think Alma is like, what, fourth or third of all her siblings, right? So Diana should be like in her 40s or something, at the minimum, late 30s. But she still hasn't grown up at all. That's what went wrong. Nobody knows. Yep, did I do it right? 12, 6, 2. Brantini. Here. This is the thing. Let's start. Boo! Oh, hell no. This is the story of a girl who grew disillusioned with one of her sisters. Soon, it became animosity, and not long after that, she distanced herself completely from said sister. With time, the girl would become attached to her elder sister, looking up to her achievements. All I can see right now are those boobs. Not now. Said sister would even marry the girl's best friend not soon after. And after the girl went into college, said sister would quit her job. The sister was worried sick about leaving her baby kid alone, prompting her to quit her high-ranking job. What if I hire your high-ranking lips? Shut up. The girl, even as an adult, felt betrayed. Her role model sister went against everything she held her in high esteem for. She was no longer a child, and yet she felt a part of her had crumbled. Hey, Joe, I can lift her sweater. Do you want to see? I bet you want to see. Alright, enough. Oh, crap. Enough? Shit. Peace out. I know the girl is you and the sister is your eldest sister. Please get to the point. Chill! Right. That was kinda rude. She was telling her story. The point is, if you don't face her, she will be heavily disappointed. She's trying to make amends with you. That must take courage. Lots of it. Yeah, you're right. My mouth's dry. Can I get a beer? Right. A beer. Man, I am going crazy, aren't I? I don't know. I don't know. Oh, why does she keep coming to bother me? Can she actually lift Elma's sweater, though, if she wanted to? I don't want Elma's sweater to be lifted, but I'm curious because that would sort of imply that she's not really just a hallucination, and that is weird. Am I good? Double, 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 all mixed. Right. Here. Thanks. So, tell me, did you and this Gabby girl get along? Oh, yeah. I've never had brothers and sisters, but once Lenore introduced me to her, as her sister-in-law, she got so excited about having a new sister that she clung to me a lot. If Lenore was using that kind of language, it sounds like maybe if the argument hadn't happened, they might even be married now. Or maybe she was just using it really early. I helped her in her studies, read books with her, played with her a lot. She was pretty much my sister, too. I have to leave, but I'll tell you this. As both a big and little sister, if you don't grant that girl the chance of talking to you, I'll never forgive you. Yeah, yeah. Oh, there's a small New Year's party this Saturday, if you're interested. Oh, sure, I'll be here. Really? You came to our Christmas party too, but don't you want to spend a little bit of time with her family? Aside from, oh, I gotta go, Diana's doing some shit again, because that's what happened last time. But, okay, you're welcome. Remember, I won't forgive you. Yeah, yeah. I'll go take my break. Alright. Ah, you were here? You were quite absorbed in the conversation just now. Jamie even said goodbye to you, didn't you hear? No, sorry, I was busy having hallucinations. Anyways, call me if anything comes up. What am I gonna do about her? What does she want from me, though? Anything in particular? I don't know. You know, I do like having a little break here. Just, have a sip of water. And reset for a second, basically. It's a very small thing, but it does help with a relaxation mood. It's less chilly today. Jill, a kid's looking for you. Already? Oh, shit. Oh, okay. This kid. I thought it was Gabby, but Gil would have recognized her too. Hey. Oh, Norma. Whew. You're back. Oh, fuck you. You do know I'm not giving you any drinks, right? That applies for the both of you. Oh, crap, I said it out loud. Yeah, actually, I wanted to thank you. Whew, she thought it was for her. Thank me? Well, for starters, by not complying and giving me alcohol. Everything else would have fallen apart if I had some. Aw, so responsible, Joe. I kind of faced my mom and told her all about the pressure she was putting on me. And said I wanted to figure out what I wanted to do. And? Well, she didn't speak to me for 2 days. After that, she told me that it'll be a waste to spend money in a university just for me to not give it my all. So she told me to still go to the college course, but that I was free to explore. What does that mean? But, glad to hear that. And, well, I wanted to thank you for that. Me? If I just rushed headfirst into my original plan, things would have gone ugly. And you were right, I would be hurting her for the sake of hurting. So, thank you. Don't worry about it. I'll leave before it's too late outside. Be careful. Aw, so sweet. Shut up. Yeah, good thing we didn't get her drunk. If she went home like that, I'm pretty sure her mom wouldn't tell her to go explore anything. Hey Jill, mind helping me here? Sure. Make a Bleeding Jane, please. On it. Okay, Bleeding Jane for Gil. What's happening at this kind of time? He sees that I'm really free, so he's saying, oh hey, help me out, cause I'm actually really busy serving multiple clients right now. Maybe that's what's happening? Do-do-do-do. All blended. Bleeding Jane. Bleeding Jane. Bleeding Jane. Thanks. Hey, Joe. Do you hate me? Hate is a harsh word. And you keep turning off the TV every single time you appear. It's not against you directly, but rather the fact that only I can see you. Like I told you, if they wanted, they could see me. And why can I? You're the main character? I don't know. What are you? A cute girl. Right. You okay, Jill? Making a lot of faces there. Yeah, just remembering stuff. Could you give me a hand here and serve a beer, please? Sure. Okay, well, hear no evil, see no evil. What was the last one again? I don't remember. You know, the whole phrase, the whole thing. Oh, can I not do a double for this one? I got too much bronze and extract. Here we go. Thanks. Would you lighten up if I showed you I can interact with the environment? Maybe it'll spook me, but let's try. Whoa! Oh my god! She just changed the HUD. There! Oh, but Jill can't see it. Is she talking to me? What the hell's happening with this girl? She is so meta. Can't see anything. You sure? Yup. Weird. She turned it back.
Nobody expects the Door of the Inquisition! Door of the Inquisition! Door of the Inquisition! Door of the Ouch! I bit my tongue! Can't believe I'm using the spare tongue so early in the night.
Oh god, do I want to know? No thank you.
Honey!
Oh, hey Dorothy.
I'm making a quick stop for a drink. Can I get a fluffy dream?
Sure. You know, one thing I really appreciate is that Dorothy never brings her clients around here. I'm not sure I can handle seeing that. Like, the whole thing in context. And maybe Dorothy likes it that way too, because she wants a place that's just for herself, not a place that she has to share with her clients and whatnot.
Thanks!
Oh, yeah, before you leave.
What? Are you guys throwing a New Year's party too?
Yup.
Sure, I'll be here then.
Well, I've got things to do, so... You do? Who does what? Sorry, I sneezed. Weird sneezes.
Anyway, I'm out for now.
Oh, yeah, Joe?
Take care of Becky, please.
Does Anna have some sort of a link to Dorothy? Yeah, because remember, Dorothy was the one talking about the whole, hey, how do you know what's real and not real? Can Dorothy see her too? No, because she was just here, and she didn't see her. But you know about Becky. Maybe that's just because she was listening to our conversations, but still, why would she care about Dorothy specifically? Hey, one time we saw her on the TV, wasn't that when Dorothy was here too? I feel like that was the case. But then Essentia could also see her, so a whole bunch of people could, not just me. Man, she was in a rush. Okay, fuck that noise. Fireworks are sold out everywhere. I'll need to get them through more shady means. She's gonna buy them from the internet. She'll find them and put us all at risk of burning. I'll make sure there's an extra extinguisher at hand. Please. We just go along with it. Well, I guess that's it for today. No, oh, pretty short day. You sure you're fine?
I am, don't worry.
Hey, Jill. Mind if I ask a silly question?
You've seen my clients. You can assume I don't mind silly questions. Silly answers can get on my nerves, though.
Sorry. What did you want to ask?
Do you know why they call them cat boomers?
I mean, I guess their second set of ears look like a cat's, but... Well, I assume it's kind of like baby boomer, right? Baby boomers are born during that one time period, and cat boomers were born during when cat ears were the boom. The fad.
The word boomer seems so out of place.
Not so much when you consider it's not them, but their parents who were called such.
Oh?
Let's go a bit back first. You do know why cat boomers look like that, right?
Because they went through some anti-nanomachine rejection treatment while they were still a fetus, right?
It's called the Yamazaki Romanova treatment. Or was it the Romanenko Yamada treatment? Let's call it the Catification procedure. It was not only the first successful genetic treatment on a fetus, but also the first way to fight nanomachine rejection. Moreover, that research had a bit of a rocky story. Funding got cut in the middle of it at a critical point that could make or break the whole thing. Not to mention, Zaibatsu Corp's record of not addressing nanomachine rejection at all.
Oh, you know a lot about random stuff, Jill. Maybe it's the science degree that you never got because... No, you did get it. You graduated.
The rest of the research was funded by Maki Stengovich. Was it Stengovich? Let's call him Stengovich for now. He's a businessman whose unborn daughter got diagnosed with early nanomachine rejection. Stengovich funded the research, and in a desperate move, his wife offered herself and her daughter as test subjects. Of course, the experiment was a success. The girl, Sylvia Stengovich, didn't die. She became the living testament of a scientific breakthrough. But then, the story of how things played out for Sylvia got sensationalized in the media and created a weird fad. Just like how, you know, idol hairstyles and whatnot. Cat ears. Parents made their unborn children go through the catification procedure, even if they had no ailments at all. Would that create any negative effects? I really hope not. Being bullied at school, maybe. All because one particular girl, whose life got saved through that treatment, became a media darling for a bit. A whole generation of kids with those cat-like protrusions got born. Is that not a thing anymore? But then people still have nanomachine rejection these days, don't they? Like Lenore, she didn't have any cat ears. Well, that's why she passed away. And their parents got called cat boomers? A generation of parents obsessed with those cat-like features. The fad quickly passed, but the term remained in use. Eventually, cat boomer just started being used for people with their protrusions instead of their parents.
You keep calling them protrusions, why is that?
Because that's what they are. Well, they're ears, can't you just call them ears? Do they not work? Huh? You didn't think those things on their heads were ears, right? What are they then? Why do we call them cat boomers if they're not cat ears? Sure, they can be moved because they're somehow connected to the facial and ear muscles. Thus, they can move like a cat and react to their mood. Oh, that's so cute! I never really noticed it, but when Stella was happy, do her ears perk up? Oh my god. That's so bad though, because we're kind of like... fetishizing the cat boomers? I don't know, I don't want to be mean to them, okay? I don't want to make you feel bad, that's all. But in the end, they were just appendages with no real function. Wait, what? The nanomachine rejection? Wasn't that treatment for it? Huh. It still surprises me a bit, though, that the biggest mutation they get after the treatment is just that.
Oh, it's like a side effect. It's not the intention of the AE treatment. That's such a random mutation. Those ears are a small miracle on their own. People have been born with no eyes for less intrusive procedures. You really thought they were functional ears, huh? Well, how would I know? Let's say I learned quite a bit today, thank you. Why the question? Don't worry, I feel like I should apologize for talking so much instead. And keep in mind, I'm fucking up the terms. I don't want you saying someone got protrusions because of a catification procedure. I'll keep it in mind. Wait! What? Yeah, the guy's name was Stengovich. Huh? I just remembered, Sylvia Stengovich was around my age, and when I was a teen, there were some TV specials featuring her. Oh, hey, I wonder if that means that Stella is a lot younger than us then, because she's got cat ears, and if Sylvia Stengovich is around my age, I assume Stella only got the treatment after the treatment became popularized, right? Because Sylvia was just the first one. Hmm. Certainly didn't seem like the case, but we can't really tell anyone's age here. And I just remembered that I had the biggest crush on her. Now that I think about it, that crush had me very confused back then. Making you wonder if you're into bestiality? And did you need to shout just now? Sorry. In any case, I'm out for the day. Alright, careful out there. Huh, short day today, huh? All booze and no firecrackers makes Dana a dull girl. Yeah. Hey, we got $1,700 today and we are sitting at $9,500. Just $500 more, one more day, and we should be okay. Probably can spare some money to buy some stuff too. Good. 30% commission for each drink. That's really dang high, isn't it? And the tips we get is pretty nice too. And the flawless service bonus. Who pays that? Dana? Another excuse for Dana to give me money? Well, not gonna say no. Thanks, boss.